leave the motorway. Same old traffic, different day. Heading for the world you recognize. Banking list does not compare with seagull sand and salty air. That's exactly when you realize you're having one of those messy moments which happen without reason or rhyme. Set your own imagination free. Your thoughts go straight to Alvin Dark, to the Berries and the 5 o'clock. No need to wonder why, it's plain to see. You're having one of those messy moments which happen without reason or rhyme. No matter where you are, however near or far, those messy moments get you every time.
This is Liverpool, one of the most famous cities in the world. Its history, its music, and its humour are just a few of the things which attract thousands of visitors all year round. This is the year when it takes on the title of European Capital of Culture. Whereas there are many activities throughout the year, one event has really captured the imagination, the 2008 Tall Ships Race. With its stunning waterfront overlooking the Mersey, it is a perfect host for the many ships taking part. It has taken 5 years of careful planning to reach this new page of local history. The city has been chosen to host the competing ships prior to the actual race. The large Class A vessels could be viewed at Wellington and Sandon Half Tide docks, and the smaller ones at Albert and Canning docks. Shuttle buses were provided to get you to and from the main dock complexes. These proved to be highly organised and most successful. First off, we visited the Wellington complex, where the weather was not very kind, but the spectacle made everyone forget the rain and the cold. The ships were stunning, and the level of craftsmanship which must have been required to create them is beyond belief. Apart from the UK and Ireland, there were vessels from all nations, including Russia, Germany, Belgium, Brazil, Sweden, Poland, Spain, Mexico, Bulgaria, Denmark, and many more. This is one of our own and is the first new tall ship to be built in Britain for over 12 years. This masterpiece was built in Bilbao in 1981. It flies the Mexican flag and is named after the last Aztec emperor. I won't even attempt to pronounce its name. The chores on board are not for the faint-hearted. No, indeed, the captain. This ship hails from Norway and was built in 1937 and is a past winner of the tall ships race. The involvement of many youngsters in this project, some of whom have never sailed, offers an adventure they will never forget. Since the first race in 1956, the event has made a remarkable contribution to international friendship. This is the Brazilian entry. Its name means white swan and was built in 2000. There were several display stands along the dockside which illustrated the unique skills of their representatives. Which you wouldn't want to argue with. Not forgetting our wonderful lifeboat service and our musical past. You can also grab a bite to eat, and in case you were wondering, yes, there was one of those as well. Getting back to the ships, this is another UK entry, which was built in 1985. Rigging, forget the weather, this is what it's all about. Liverpool first hosted the tall ships back in 1984, then again in 1992. But this year, being Capital of Culture year, makes it a bit special. This is the Uruguay entry. Hard to believe, it was built in 1930. After saying goodbye to Wellington Dock, the shuttle bus took us to the Albert Dock complex to take a look at the smaller competitors. The weather here had improved slightly, and again the spectacle was quite breathtaking. And the atmosphere, electric. Again, all nations were on display. This classic hails from the Netherlands and is joining the race for the first time. It's pretty obvious where this one comes from. It was built in 1981. The Pogoria is Poland's entry and was built in 1980. Quayside, you realise how natural all these vessels look in this environment. For after all, this is why the docks were built in the first place. It's like stepping back in time. The 19th century Albert Dock Complex has been totally renovated and brought into the 21st century. And with its shops and bars, it is a perfect place to socialise. But the presence of these wonderful vessels gives it another dimension for the short time they're here. On Monday the 21st of July, the ships gathered in the Mersey to prepare for the eagerly awaited parade of sail. One by one, they sail upriver to await the turning of the tide. The crowds gathered along both banks of the river. On the Wirral side, you could almost reach out and touch the ships as they passed by. Apart from the thousands of onlookers along the coastline, one or two took to the water for a close-up view. While all these preparations were being made, we were treated to a magnificent air display. Nerves of steel and inch-perfect precision. Great stuff. Treated to a bit of impromptu entertainment in the shape of an amphibious car. Although not part of the parade, this chap wasn't going to wait for the tide to turn and decided to sail against the current, which was probably in the region of 10 miles per hour. Now, when your craft is only capable of 5 miles per hour and there's a multitude of sailing ships in your rear view mirror towards which you are involuntarily reversing, you are bound to attract the attention of the lifeboat. And in this case, a helicopter. And even a warship. Happily, our unfortunate mariner was towed to safety and the parade of sail could get underway, which was heralded by a giant water spray from a sturdy tugboat. We could now watch the ships we had seen at close range sail past in their full glory. They initially sailed from their positions upriver to pass the Liverpool waterfront, then swing across the river towards Seacombe, then downriver and into the Liverpool Bay. As we have already mentioned, a large number of these vessels were constructed many years ago, and they still look in superb condition, and still, in fact, do the job they were designed for. Perhaps modern car manufacturers should take note. The fleet would head north to an area off the coast of Northern Ireland, where the race would actually begin on the 23rd of July. They would race around the top of Scotland and across the North Sea to Molloy in Norway, where they were to spend 4 days. They were then to sail to Bergen, then on to Den Helder in the Netherlands. And it doesn't get any better than that.